we here with Team Benavides. How is your camp going, guys?
Well, everything's going well. We've been in camp almost for, I would say, 3 months now. We were in Oregon for 3 weeks also, just doing the strength condition. And now we're back in Big Bear, and we're training really hard. This fight is really important for us. It's going to be a WBC Eliminator title, so we're ready.
That's huge.
Super huge, super huge. After this, eventually we're going to be fighting for the world title, the WBC world title. So we're really excited, and like I said, we're putting a lot of sacrifice, a lot of time into this fight, and hopefully everything goes well. I don't see why not. You know, we're very prepared for this fight.
So how are you feeling, David?
I'm feeling very great. You know, I'm really blessed to have this opportunity in front of me. It's a big opportunity for me. I've been, you know, working my ass off. I have 4 months since this camp. 3.5 months or 4 months training for this camp. You know, so I'm very excited, very prepared, and ready to take care of business on May 20th.
All right, I gotta ask you this, guys. Canelo Chavez Jr., break it down.
For me, I think it's a very interesting fight. I'm waiting for that fight. It's almost a week away from now. I want to lean a little towards more Chavez because he's a little bit bigger. And I think he proved that he has a good chin. His activity hasn't been that well, but Canelo's been a little bit more active. But Chavez is more bigger, and that's why I'm leaning to him a little bit more. I think it's going to be an exciting fight. If somebody gets hurt, it might be Canelo, in my opinion. You know, I'm not trying to offend nobody, but he's a bigger puncher, a bigger man in there. I don't think Canelo has the power to knock Chavez out. It might go to decision, in my opinion.
You're a great trainer. If you were in a corner for either Canelo or Chavez, what would your game plan be?
Well, if I was with Chavez, maybe I, you know, to be honest with you, it's not, sometimes it's not about the trainer. You know, he's already been made, you know. It's, what can you show Chavez for this fight? You know, I think it's just trying to work on his condition, and hopefully he comes with good condition, and I think he's gonna take care of business. Hopefully he's not weak, losing all that weight, you know. But then you will have to adjust in that time and how in that fight, how it goes. I think it will be a little bit hard, I think. You know, you will have to adjust to every round.
What do you think, David? Who you got?
I feel like it's gonna be a very great fight. You know, I think Chavez could have the edge if he uses his jab and boxes a little bit, but to be honest, I don't think he's in the box. It's not his style. I think he's just going there, go toe to toe with them. And that might, you know, that might favor Alvarez, because Alvarez is a toe to toe fighter, and he has a strong punch. And he's more comfortable at that weight. You know, but Chavez had 4 or 5 months to prepare for the fight, so he shouldn't be weak at all. He should be good on weight. Fight, you know, it's an intense fight and I can't wait to see it myself.
Going back to that thing again, these two fighters, they're fighting more for pride, you know. So I think none of them is going to back up, both of them are going to want to bring it, you know, because they have to do it for the fans. You know, they got to prove that they're their best. You know, they're just gonna, hopefully they listen to their corners, but they're just gonna come in and try to knock each other out, I think.
Joshua Klitschko.
Oh man, that's another fight that I want to see right now. Actually, when I go back, I'm gonna go with Joshua because I think he's younger, he moves a little bit more, he's more hungry. Klitschko, you know, he's older, he's slower, but anything can happen in that way, you know, a lucky shot. But I'm gonna go with Joshua.
No, I think Joshua might take that fight too. It's gonna be a great fight. You know, Klitschko is one of the greatest heavyweights of all time. His jab and his 1-2 is amazing, but I think he's a little bit ahead of his time now, and Joshua looks like he's in his prime, so I'm going for Joshua.
Ward Kovalev rematch.
I'll go with Kovalev, I think. You know, it was a pretty close fight. It's going to be an exciting fight, but this, I think Kovalev would take it.
Oh, I think it's going to be a little bit... I think Kovalev might take this one only because he's mad from the first one, how they took it from him. I think he would put a little bit more pressure. He was very dangerous with that 1-2, and that jab was very effective. And I think he's going to do more of that. I think he's going to use this training camp. He's just going to train like a beast and come out, you know, really really prepared for this fight. But, you know, you can never count Andre Ward out. He's a great fighter as well. This is going to be another great fighter.
All right, so there you have it. And tell everybody how to follow you on your social media.
Well, everybody can follow me at Facebook. It's Jose Benavides. Instagram, Jose Benavides, also senior. And first of all, too, you know, I want to thank you guys for the opportunity, for always supporting us and give us good interviews. And I want to thank the people also, all the Mexican fans and American fans and everybody, you know, all the Hispanics and everybody that always support us from day one.
Right, and what's yours?
Mine is, well, you didn't even tell where to find, you can find you on Instagram.
Like you said it.
I did it.
Oh, I did it?
Yeah.
Mine is David_Benavides_300.
Right.
You know, I'll give you guys all the information there is about me there. Thank you.
All right, so there you have it.